Hi everyone, so in today's video we are going to look upon a topic known as bypass authentication, and for that particular topic we are going to test upon a platform known as OWASP BWA, that is OWASP Broken Web Application Project, and we'll go ahead and we'll click on this particular platform, testing platform, that is OWASP Bricks, and simply we'll go ahead to the Bricks and then login pages, and as you can see we have 6 challenges to solve. Out of the 6, I'll show you only the first 5 because the last one is not actually working properly. So let's begin with our first challenge. As you can see, we have been given a login form and we have to basically bypass this authentication. Okay, so normally what I'll do is I'll just simply write admin and pass, and I'll just see what this web application is returning to us. Simply I'll click on submit and we can see the SQL query that is being reflected over here. Okay, now I'll just simply copy this particular SQL query and I'll go to the text editor and we'll simply paste it. I'll just delete the front letters, the alphabets and all, and only the required thing to be kept. Now as you can see, this name is a parameter and so the password. Okay, now admin is the value that we have passed in the form in the input text field, and similarly pass is the value as well. That means whenever we are giving admin and pass as our value, these values are getting stored within the single quotes. That means if I put, for example, B at the last, then also over here B will be added by the web application itself. So what we can do is we can actually put a single quote over here. Now what will happen is if I just put a single quote over here, okay, that means if I just put a single quote over here, what will happen, this will become first close. Okay, means this will become a ideal case. Okay, if I put a single quote over here, then this particular string is now complete. Okay, now you can see we have extra your single quotes left with, okay, and this extra single quote will help us to generate our bypass, means will basically help us to bypass the authentication. That means if I now write OR, then this particular thing will be reflected like this. Okay, and then if I just write within single quotes 1 is equals to, again only single quote open and like this, then how this will go is like over here. That means I'll simply write 1 is equals to 1 with a single quote over here. Okay, so basically from here till here, okay, from here till here will be our payload. Okay, this particular portion. Okay, so basically this will be our payload. How this payload will work, simply if I just copy and paste this payload over here, what the database will think is that from this, from the very starting, from here to this particular single quote, this is a perfect string, and then there is a command execution portal which is left opened. Okay, and now we are executing OR 1 equals to 1. Now why we are enclosing our numbers within single quotes, because here we have an extra single quotes, that's why to balance the equation or to balance the query we are using single quotes. Fine, now simply what the database will understand, the database will understand that if there is a user name as admin, then log me inside the portal or just return 1 equals to 1. So what this particular query will return, 1 equals to 1 will return a boolean value of true. That means if there exists an user known as admin, then also give me the permission to go inside the portal, and if not, then check whether the condition is true or not. If the condition is true, then give me the permission to go inside the portal. Alright, so this particular thing will be our payload. Alright, and similarly for here as well, what we'll do is we'll do just the same thing. Likewise, we'll add a single quotes. Again, we'll write or, and then we'll write 1 is equals, one. Okay, you can even write 2 is equals to 2. Okay, there is no such necessary that you have to put 1 equals to 1. What necessary is that the condition that you are writing after this or statement, okay, the condition that you are writing after this or statement should return true. If you write 1 not equals to 2 also, this particular thing will also return true. Okay, so make sure to return the condition as true. Okay, so we'll use this particular payload. Okay, so let's copy this and go ahead to our browser, simply paste this. And what we'll do, we'll just simply copy it and paste it over here as well, and then we'll click on submit, and you can see we have been successfully logged in. Okay, and this is the query. You can see it has been perfectly balanced as we have expected, where name equals to admin or 1 is equals to 1 and password equals to admin or 1 equals to 1. Okay, so this particular query is perfectly balanced, and hence we have been able to bypass the authentication. This is challenge 1 that we saw. Let's go ahead and go for the challenge 2. Simply what we'll do is we'll again write admin and pass and see what is the thing that we are getting over here. Here is the same thing as well, okay, but this time the method will be something different. Okay, so let's actually see. Again, we'll remove the front queries and this over here. Now, as you might expect, that we might use the payload admin or 1 is equals to 1. Okay, now this particular query is perfectly valid, but what will happen if we use this? Let's use it. Let's see what will happen. It says the query is too long. Okay, the query is too long, means we cannot use things like that. So for that, what we'll do is we'll turn on our burp suite and we have to intercept the request. Okay, so let's go ahead and turn on our burp suite. So we'll click on next, start burp, and we'll wait for the burp suite to load. Simply we'll click on next and start burp. I think I have turned on burp 2 times. Let me close any of it. Okay, let it turn on. Okay, so our burp is ready and running. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll just simply copy the URL. Okay, and we'll just minimize our window. We'll go to the burp suite and we'll maximize it. Okay, we'll go to the proxy tab. As you can see, we'll click on this particular blue button, which is intercept on, and we'll just turn off the intercept. We'll open a browser which is pre-configured of burp suite. We'll just click on open browser and the browser will start over here, and now we'll keep burp suite over here and the browser over here, and now we'll paste it and simply we'll go to it. Okay, so this is where our login page is. Now we'll turn the intercept on, and here we'll write, for example, let me just write my name Sabya and let me just write title Paul. Okay, and now if I hit submit, you can see my request has been captured over here. This is the header of the request and this is the body of the request. Between the header and the body, always there will be a gap. Okay, as you can see, the request is a post request. Okay, and the request is being sent to this particular IP address at port 80. Okay, so, and also you can see this is running on HTTP version 1.1 and so on and so forth. So what we can do is we can simply intercept the request. Now, as you saw, we cannot modify or we cannot bypass it directly from the login form or from the web application. So we will modify our request from the verb suite itself, which it has intercepted for us. Similarly, we'll add our payload in that particular place. Now what we'll do is we'll just simply add a semicolon over here. Again, we'll write or, we'll add one is equals to one. Okay, that's all. And simply we'll go to Paul as well. We'll put a single quote and we'll write or. Again, we'll put a single quote. Within single quote, we'll write one is equals to one. Okay. Only writing this much, only writing our payload this much, when this will be sent to the database, then you will see what will happen. Now if I just do forward, you can see we have been successfully logged in. Okay, and as you can see, the query is perfectly balanced without any error. Okay, so this is how we can bypass the authentication for level 2 of WASP bricks. Okay, now let's go ahead into level 3. So let's go for level 3. Okay, or let's manually go to basic login. Okay, simply we'll just again write admin and we'll write again write password, and you can see here we get a some different type of query again. Okay, but not to worry, this particular challenge is simple. Once again, simply we'll delete the unnecessary things. Okay, and simply we'll delete this particular thing as well. This is the place we have to focus. Okay, now what is happening is whenever giving the value admin, this is being added over here. Okay, if I write s will be added over here as well. If I write password, the password is being added over here, and simply if I write s over here, the s will be added over here. So we have to basically finish this particular thing. Okay, now how to actually do it? Now what if I add a single quote and a bracket? Similarly, the single quote will come over here as well. Okay, and a bracket will be added over here as well. Now according to the database, from here to here, this is a valid query. This particular thing will raise an problem. Okay, now to solve it, what we'll do is simple. Again, we'll go and we'll write or. Okay, and then we'll basically type a single quote again. Okay, and we'll write one, and again we'll write a single quote. Okay, and then we'll put equals to, and then again this. So basically our payload is this particular thing. Okay, but it's not like that. We have to add the parenthesis as well, because it is being enclosed within the parenthesis. So we have to add the parenthesis as well. So our payload will be from here to here. Okay, yeah, see, this particular thing will be our payload. We can remove the s now. What is actually happening is admin is being written over here. Okay, so basically let me show you from the beginning. I'm writing admin and then it is being closed, bracket closed. This is a perfect query. Now or, I am opening a first bracket and I'm opening a single quote. Again, I'm writing one, closing the quote and closing the bracket is equals to this and this. Now when I'll write this, there is an automatically the single quote and a closing first bracket will come by the database itself. Okay, so to balance, this will be our payload. Basically this particular thing will be our payload. Okay, now if we just simply copy it, and if you go to our browser and if we just simply paste it, and do the same over here as well. And if we just click on submit, you will see we have been successfully logged in. And if you see the query, that is select star from users when name is equals to admin, which is perfectly balanced till here, or 1 is equals to 1. And as you can see, we have just entered our payload till here, and the first parenthesis, the first bracket and the single quotes, and the trailing single quote and the first bracket has been added by the database itself. Okay, so our payload has been injected within the query. Okay, and the same thing happened for the password parameter as well, and you can simply ignore this particular part of the query, that is limit 0, 1. Okay, so we have been able to successfully logged in. Now simply we'll go ahead and we'll try for login 4 as well. We'll check what's the issue over here. Admin and pass. Simply you can see instead of single quotes, there are double quotes as well. So now I want you guys to write in the comment section fast before I explain you. I'm waiting for 5 seconds. Please write down the payload in the comment section. I'm waiting for you. Try to answer, okay? Alright, time's up, so I hope that you were able to answer, and if not, then let's see how can we actually bypass it. Simply, we have added the word admin and it has came over here. Okay, as you can see, when I'm highlighting it, it has came over here. Now I'll add a your double quotes, okay, and then I'll add a bracket, okay, a closing bracket. So this particular scenario is done. And now we know that another bracket is waiting for us over here. So to balance this, what we'll use is or a first bracket, double quotes, 1 double quotes close, brackets close is equals to double quotes on, brackets on, double quotes on, and within that 1. Okay. So basically this will be our payload, and as you know, there is always your, that's right over here, always your this particular thing, and this particular thing is being automatically added by the database itself. Okay, so there is no need for the attacker to add this manually, because if we add this manually, then this particular thing will not be balanced and hence it will raise a problem. Okay, so we'll simply delete the forward trailing things, and this is what our payload will look like, just like the previous one where it has it had single quotes, we have now double quotes. Simply we'll just go and paste it over here and here. And if you click on submit, you can see we have been successfully logged in to our account. Okay, easy enough. Now let's check for password in MD5. Now the password generated will be in a MD5 hash format. Okay, simply we'll put our credentials, and as you can see, this is what our query somewhat looks like. All right, this is how our query looks like. Great. So what we'll do again, we'll do the necessary things, we'll remove the unnecessary things, and we'll keep the required things. As you can see, all those things. Now if you don't know, in each and every programming language there is a concept known as comments. Okay, comments are basically used to leave notes or special messages within the code, and those comment will never get executed whenever the code is executed. Okay, means the comment will never be visible. Okay, so in SQL there is a syntax for commenting, that is either a hashtag or either exclamation mark then dash dash. Okay, or you can write dash dash plus, or you can write dash space dash dash plus. It depends from application to application. Okay, so we'll try with hashtag first. Okay, so we have our admin over here. Okay, fine, great. We'll add a single quote to balance the query. Now we'll write or, and simply we can just write 1 equals to 1. Now there is no need to add single quotes. What we'll do now is we'll just simply add a hashtag. What this will do, this will basically provoke a, means this will basically comment all the things from here till here. Okay, now how basically this thing will look like is, we have added a semicolon, I mean a single quote, then or, 1 equals to 1, and then a hashtag. So basically from the hashtag itself, this particular thing will be deleted, will be of no use. So basically this is what our database will be simply running. Okay, so this is what our payload will be. The hashtag will be commenting all the trailing queries. Now if I just copy and paste on the username, and if we just leave the password itself, doesn't matter. So let's check while leaving the password itself. Click on submit. So it's a mandatory field, no problem. We can write anything we want, some random stuff, doesn't matter. If we click on submit, you can see that we have been successfully logged in. And by this tutorial, we come to the finishing point of our authentication bypass technique. And as I have told you that sixth part is not functioning properly, so let me see over here. And without just giving the credential, if I just click on the button over here, you can see it is telling like we are successfully logged in. And also if I just put random values and if I just click enter, then also you said you are successfully logged in. Basically this particular thing is not functioning properly. So I've showed you from 1 to 5. Okay, so this is, now we come to the finishing point of our authentication bypass topic, and I hope that you like the video. And this is all for today, so have a good day.